Well, one of you to be here this morning. I had someone ask me this week, they said, well, now if I come on Mass Saturday night, is that a twofer? I said, no, it's not. Why do we have these holy days to begin with? The holy days are because there is a doctrine of the faith that is part of what we believe that the church doesn't want us to forget. So you know what the holy days are. The ones surrounding Mary are always holy days. Now the bishops of the different dioceses can pick whether or not, like the Ascension, or that's what we say in the Creed, that we believe the Lord ascended into heaven, the body and the soul. So that's a Thursday, Ascension Thursday. But some dioceses, they transfer it to a Sunday, right? And then there's All Saints Day is a holy day. But now if it fell on a Saturday, they would take away the obligation. Some dioceses. The bishops can't get on the same page. But if it's a feast of Mary, and there are two, the Immaculate Conception and August 15th, the Assumption of Mary. Well, now why do we celebrate the Immaculate Conception on December the 8th? That's because we celebrate her birthday on September the 8th. Now, it gets to be quite confusing because the gospel is the Annunciation, isn't it? It's Mary giving word and being asked if she would be the mother of Jesus. This is not the Annunciation we celebrate, Mary's conception of Christ. What we celebrate today is Mary's conception. Joachim and Anne, her parents, that Mary was conceived without sin. That's why there's 9 months between September the 8th and December the 8th. When do we celebrate the Annunciation? March 25th. 9 months before December 25th. You see, that's about Mary conceiving Christ. The doctrine of the faith surrounding the Immaculate Conception is Mary's conception, that God preserved her from original sin so that she could be the mother of Christ. And so, well, how could that be? Well, God is not in time. He's not limited by time. We are. God applied to the soul of Mary the graces that Jesus would redeem us by at her conception, prior to him in time dying on the cross. Why? Because all of humanity was in sin. God's choosing Mary to be the mother of Christ. She has to be in grace. She can't be in sin to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit and to be the mother of the second person of the Trinity. She has to be in harmony with God. So God has to allow that to be the case. So if you listen closely to that opening prayer, it says God applied to her ahead of time the grace that her son gained for all humanity so that she could be in harmony with God in order to conceive the Son of God. That's what this feast means. And that's why the church insists on us celebrating it. So we understand great generosity of God. But at the same time, there's the great generosity of Mary. Because even though God gave her the grace to be the mother of God, he still asked her permission. Now there's two things for us to remember on this feast day for ourselves. Number one, God gives all of us everything we need to do what he wants us to do in our lives. The second is that he respects our will absolutely. God does not force us to do anything. He invites us to do his will. He asked Mary, and she said yes. Notice something else. That angel didn't tell her the whole story. She might have said no. He didn't tell her everything. He only told her the good stuff. He didn't say anything about him suffering and dying on the cross, and you're going to watch him be persecuted. You're going to watch him be brutally beaten and crucified. God can't tell us everything because sometimes we can't take it. It's better that we don't know everything. But in the midst of whatever may happen, God is with us, and we can overcome it all. So we have to trust him. Mary said yes not just one time, but many times. And the hardest yes was not when the angel asked her to do the impossible. The hardest yes was when she watched her son be crucified. And that's why we love her.